When investing on margin, you may not realize a profit if the rate at which you borrow is greater than your anticipated return. Of course, there is no way to predict actual returns, but you can compare margin rates. Nick Watney, Operations Manager and Senior Vice President for Zions Direct, is here with us to explain how these rates are determined. How are you, Nick? Thanks for joining us.
I'm doing well, thank you.
How are margin rates determined?
So margin rates are determined differently at many different broker-dealers, but a simple way of looking at it is they have a base rate that they're lending from, and then they'll have tiers on those rates. So many broker-dealers will have an internal lending rate that may be published just on their own site, and others will use a more generally accepted rate, such as Zions Direct. We use broker call as our base rate.
So Zions Direct is determining its own rates. Is that what you're saying?
That is what I'm saying. Essentially what happens is Zions Direct has a base rate, which is broker call. Mm-hmm. And then we have a tiered system in place. And we recently simplified that tiered system and basically said if you borrow $1 million or more, you pay one rate. And if you borrow less than $1 million, you pay another. So let me give you an example. Let's say broker call was 2%. At Zions Direct, if you are borrowing over $1 million, our rate for loans over $1 million is 2% minus 0.5%. So in this case, it would be 1.5%. Whereas if you were borrowing less than $1 million, it would be the 2%, the broker call, plus 0.25%, so 2.25%.
So now that we know what our rate is, just like if we were going out to shop for a loan, it's important to know what interest rate you're going to be paying, right? Why is that so important?
Well, it's particularly important in the investing world because many of us are looking for a particular rate of return on our investments. So let me give you an example with slightly different margin rates. Let's say our margin rate was 3% in what we're borrowing. And let's say our rate of return on our securities was 2%. Well, obviously, that's not a very good deal because we're going to be paying out more than what we're bringing in. Now, let's say our rate of return was 4%. Though we're only making the 1%, we are still making money. So it is really important to know what your rate is, and that's why make sure you look and ask when signing up for a margin account.
I know that margin is really a risky type of investment, but there are upsides and downsides to both. Give us an example of each.
Sure. So really, margin is going to allow you to leverage your account and to, in an up market, that really is going to allow you to bring in a greater rate of return. Hopefully, you're returning a lot better than your interest rate. But there's also some risks. So if your securities tend to go, if they're going down or if the market is going down, then you might end up in what they call a margin call, in which case your broker may ask you to bring additional monies to satisfy your debt or may end up selling your securities to satisfy your debt if you can't bring in the money.
So if somebody wants to get started with a margin account, what do they need to do?
Well, the first thing they need to do is talk to somebody who's qualified, because really there are so many different facets to margin that you want to talk to somebody not only who's used a margin account, but somebody who's licensed and understands all the risks and the pitfalls that come with margin. So, my suggestion is talk to somebody like those at Zions Direct that are licensed and have that experience and can help you use this as a tool rather than as a pitfall in your account.
Nick, thank you so much for joining us today. It's been so great having you here.
Thank you.
If you have any questions about margin or would like to open a margin account, please give us a call at 800-524-8875. And to see more videos like this, subscribe to the Zions Direct YouTube channel.